I think it's amazing, really, to be able to see things inside, to be able to visualize. I mean, if you think about it, it's rather odd to be able to just turn your attention inside and picture a face or a familiar place. Something comfortable, enjoyable. To actually be able to see its shape, its colors, the large, broad strokes of the inner image, and even the details, every little edge, texture. I mean, not every image is that way, and sometimes the images are vague. I have an easier time visualizing shapes, spaces, objects, and it's a little more difficult for me to visualize somebody's face, for example, to remember just exactly what they look like. This ability to see both outside and to be able to see inside is really quite remarkable. I think I grew up just thinking that we had an imagination, but it's a whole host of inner senses, seeing, hearing, feeling. So much more. I think with most people, the visualization is the most prominent image. I heard somebody say that 80% of the people out there, that they rely mostly on the visualization. And I've noticed that I can pull up an image in front of me, like a movie screen. Or I can actually go into the image as if I am in it, like I'm in a room and I can look at all four walls and the ceiling, the floor. That's another surprising thing, that there's these two ways of looking at it, sort of projecting or being in the image itself. And then sometimes I feel like I'm creating an image, like I'm manufacturing it or fabricating it. And other times the image just appears all by itself. Where did that come from? The image just appears. I wonder if those two are the same thing. If I want to make something appear, where does my interest in something, where does that come from? Is it because the image comes first and then I grab onto it and say, that's what I want to visualize? Or I don't know. I know when I'm looking for a creative idea, or I'd like a little more information about something, you know, whether it's a pain in the body or an illness or some bit of conflict socially with somebody else, I like giving that space, that sort of opening, and then letting the image come all by itself. That seems to be most interesting, like it has the most information or is most illuminating. That's right. I mean, what is this image anyway? It's so easy to like say it's a, can be rendered into words. Like this means this, that means that, and so it all gets translated into some piece of intellectual material. I always feel like I'm missing so much when I do that. When something appears inside, it's nice to participate, to be a co-creator. I mean, what is the image asking of me? Where does it want to take me? Assuming it has a life of its own, a spirit of its own, I would definitely call these images alive. There's no doubt about that. I mean, what is more alive than that creative spirit that rises in me and gives form to all kinds of creativity, imagination, fantasy, that literally is the predecessor of my action, my movement? I want something. I see it first. It comes to mind as an image, and then I take action. Yes, that part of that inner seeing and having those images arise, the meaningful images, that's getting pretty close to the heart of aliveness, I would say. Sometimes it's fun to see an object and just turn it around, looking at the different sides. I know when something appears to me, it appears a little bit vague at first. It's as if I know what it is in a general way. And then looking at it, not grasping too hard, but looking at it, the details begin to form. All the edges and the color, the textures, it becomes more real, complete. Yes. And then I can just hold that object, that mental object in my mind, and its spirit begins to become clear. I begin to know how it fits in with this and that, all the other things in my life. What its energy, its intention is, or its usefulness, how it fits in. And why not just leave it as an image? Why not leave it as the image that's empowering, motivating, informing? No need to render it to words and intellect. Just let it have the life of its own. But are we now venturing into the realm of feeling? I always like listening to an image. A wide open field with one strong oak tree. The wind blowing enough that the leaves are rustling. What a unique sound that is. And I can see the movement of the leaves, so many leaves. And then a light rain starts, it falls on the leaves, and there's a new sound. And very soon this becomes so immersive, it's not just about seeing, it's about hearing. It's about being in the space and have the whole visualization wrap all around me. And then feeling each part. How does the trunk of this oak tree feel? And what sort of empowering spirit is it? How is that different than these new leaves that are appearing just this season? Very green and tender. How are those different? How is the rain, the wind, all of it, just all of it is such a rich conversation to be immersed in. What a magnificent inner world we have. What a magnificent inner life there is inside.